Brentech, yeah, where tech is made simple. So earlier this week, if you haven't heard already, Microsoft has announced that they are going to be making changes to Office, and that Office is going to become Microsoft 365. So as in my case, if we just head over to office.com, you may have seen and noticed this banner already, which says the Office app is becoming the new Microsoft 365 app. And yeah, you can see the icon is also being changed and taking on a whole new brand new look and feel. Now, I thought in this video we could just go through a couple of those changes, just in case there was any confusion as to the Office app becoming the new Microsoft 365 app. Now, Microsoft says that office.com, the Office mobile app, and the Office app for Windows will become the Microsoft 365 app, and that's in the next coming months. And that's with a new icon, a new look, and even more features. And I actually posted on one of those new features yesterday, which is the new Microsoft Designer application. And I will leave a link to that video in the description if that would be of interest. Now, the changes will begin rolling out for office.com in November 2022. So that's next month. And in true Microsoft fashion, though, they don't give us an exact date in November. So we can expect that to be a controlled, phased, staggered rollout. And then if you are using the Office app on Windows or the Office mobile app, those changes will begin rolling out next year in January 2023. Now, Microsoft does say that the changes will apply to everyone who uses the Office app for work, school, or personal use. And there will be no impact to your existing account, your profile, your subscription, and to your files. So there's no concern there, according to Microsoft. And the app will automatically update with a new icon and name as mentioned. Now, if you're asking the question, so what is Microsoft 365? According to Microsoft, it's a cloud-powered productivity platform that's going to include apps like Microsoft Teams, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, OneDrive, just to mention a couple of examples. And you can get started with the free web and mobile apps or upgrade to a premium plan and for access to more apps, storage, and features. So in a nutshell, the Microsoft 365 app is just going to be part of the whole Microsoft 365 suite of apps. So that's just a very simple way to look at it. It's just going to be part of all the Microsoft 365 suite of apps. Now, just to mention a couple of the changes very quickly, that's going to be made available in the new Microsoft 365 app. There's going to be new types of content creation and templates, new apps module, welcome badging, my content. There's going to be a feed and also tagging. And if you're concerned about the individual Office products like Word, Excel, or PowerPoint, those aren't going to be rebranded or have any changes made. They're going to stay exactly the same. And the standalone versions of Office themselves, as an example, Office 2021, just to mention that, as an example, nothing there is going to be changing. There's going to be no changes in the regard to the standalone versions of Office. So hopefully that clears up things a little bit, and I hope you found this video useful. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.